31, I had a request for section 2.6, number 37 from your homework. So this is asking us to solve a quadratic equation, or I shouldn't say quadratic, it's technically a quartic because this is degree 4, but it's in quadratic form. So we'll say we are solving, oops, that's not how you spell solving. Solving a quartic equation that is in quadratic form. So what that typically means is whenever we're looking at these quartics or whatever equation you have in quadratic form, you always want to look at whatever the middle term is. And the deal with this is if you can take this middle term and you can square it and you can get to this lead term, then this method works. So what I mean by that is if I look at the middle term right now and just the variable, I don't need the coefficient, it's x squared. Now, if I square that term, if I take x squared squared, and when you have x squared squared, when you have a power raised to a power, you multiply those exponents, you get x to the fourth. And I'll put a little check there because my first term was x to the fourth. So if that happens, then we know this method will work. And if it doesn't happen, then this solving an equation in quadratic form, it's not gonna work. But it's ready to go, it's going to work. So what you do at that point is you take that middle term, let me go ahead and erase this. You take this middle term here, actually let me do it in highlighter, this middle term, and that becomes your u. So let's start to work this. I'm going to let u equal x squared. And then what you do is you figure out what u squared is equal to. Well, if u is equal to x squared, and let me change colors here. If I were to square both sides, so let me do this over here. If u is equal to x squared, oops, and I square both sides, right, I will ultimately wind up on the left side with u squared, as I have written here, and that will be equal to, well, x squared squared is x to the fourth. Now, we already checked that up top here, but I just want you to see it playing out. All right, so here's my u sub that I'm going to use. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take a look at this initial equation, and everywhere you see a term with x in it, you're going to write a different term with u in it. So what I mean by that is I can see right here directly this x squared, I'm going to rewrite it as u. This x to the fourth, I'm going to rewrite as u squared. And that's where I get to this equation. So instead of writing x to the fourth, let's write u squared. Instead of writing negative 10x squared, let's write negative 10u. Now, 9 in and of itself, it has no variables in it. It's a constant, and that's why it stays a constant. All right, and then once you're here, you can see now I do have a quadratic equation. I have a quadratic equation with u's in it, but I still have a quadratic equation. And as we learned in the last section, you can either factor it, you can use the quadratic formula, or you can complete the square. And I opted to factor. I told you before, that is by far my favorite method, if I can do it. And then the one I would go to after was quadratic formula, and I try and avoid completing the square. And this one's not too terrible. It factors right out, right? We got u minus 9, u minus 1. So you see me using the zero product property. I'm going to set u minus 9 equal to 0. All right, and that gets me u equaling 9. I'm also going to set u minus 1 equal to 0. Right? So let me just go with it over here in case it helps to look at it a little less vertically. So I have either u minus 9 is equal to 0 or u minus 1 is equal to 0. So I get that u is equal to 9 or u is equal to 1. And that's all great. But if we go all the way back to my original, let me get my highlight, my original equation, I started with x's. So if you look at this, if you start with x variables, you have to end with x variables. And where I am right now, so far, I just have u's. All right, so I haven't finished my problem, but I do have a u substitution, right? We remember, ooh, I zoomed in somehow, fun. We do have this relationship that u is equal to x squared. So what that means is I'm going to substitute that in Oh, let me use a different color. I'm going to substitute that in right here. I'm going to take u is equal to x squared, and I'm going to sub back. So then I know that x squared is equal to 9, or x squared is equal to 1. And then I can square root both sides, making sure to remember the pluses and minuses, and I will get x is equal to plus or minus 1 or plus or minus 3, and when I write that out, there we go. Right? Now again, I started with x's, I ended with x's. Hold on, let me do different colors and say that dramatically again. I started with x's and I ended with x's. And there's solving a quadratic, or I should say solving an equation that's in quadratic form. All right, thanks so much, gang. Bye.